In this video, I'm going to show you guys how to make an epic looking YouTube end screen like this by just using the tool PowerPoint. So without further ado, let's get started. All right, so here's the first thing you need to do when creating an end screen for your YouTube videos. What I recommend is going to your YouTube account, make sure you already have a video uploaded, and then what you want to do is you actually want to go in the edit section and then go to where there's an end screen. So I'm going to show you guys this right here. So basically, you see right here, I'm actually going to discard changes real quick. So let's say you're adding in your details, then you go to video elements, and now you want to add an end screen. You go here to add. Then it's going to show you all these different templates that YouTube has already provided you. You can also customize how you want your YouTube end screen to look. But for now, I'm just going to import from my latest video the type of template I created, because this is just the same template I use for every video, and I'm just going to add it right here. So now what's showing is these two boxes are actually videos. One of them is going to be best reviewer, and then one might be like what's recommended, and then this box right here is actually where my face is going to show up for people to click on to possibly subscribe. So the reason why I have you guys in this is because what I want you guys to do is take any type of screenshot tool you might have and just screen clip this box right here. So I'm going to show you guys how to do that right now. So for my computer in particular, I actually have a tool called the snipping tool. So you guys might have like the grab tool if you're using a Mac. And what you can do is you just hit new, and this can work for any screenshot tool. And you just want to highlight this section right here. Okay. So once you highlight that section, make sure to save that image to your desktop or wherever you feel comfortable with. And then we're going to bring that image into PowerPoint. All right. So now that you're in PowerPoint and you've imported your end screen screenshot, we're now going to use this as our template to follow when designing our end screen in PowerPoint. So this is really important for us to have because it'll allow us where to put information on the screen so that it doesn't get cut off or it kind of looks unaligned whenever your end screen pops up for the end user. All right, so now what you want to do with the screenshot is actually copy it and put it in a new slide like so, and just have it fill the entire slide. So it should be that 16:9, the same kind of dimensions that PowerPoint is already for slides. All right, so now you just want to fit it into that 16:9 presentation. So it should fit perfectly because in PowerPoint they're the same dimensions as what your video is on YouTube. And now what this is telling you is basically this is where your subscribe button or your profile pic is going to show up. This is where the two videos are going to show up. And now you can add all these designs you want right here, or maybe you want to put like your face right here like how I did. So basically what I did is I put my face right here and it was kind of just in this section like so, and then what I did was I put a circle and that was going to be placed right here, and that's basically the placeholder for my YouTube thumbnail profile pic. Now you don't have to actually put that white circle on the end screen template when you upload it to use for your YouTube videos, but that's just to give you a good frame of reference as to like where it's going to appear. Some people like to add that, some people even like to add the boxes of where the video is going to be placed on your end screen. Sometimes I don't actually like to do that because let's say someone's like turning their phone a bunch and then maybe that white box is showing underneath it because like maybe the videos are off. So that's why I wouldn't recommend adding in those boxes, but just give yourself space to put those boxes right there, and that's going to be where your two recommended videos are. So another thing for my end screen is that I actually included a background video that's playing as my two suggested videos pop up and my thumbnail picture. So there's a little bit of movement happening just slightly in the background. So I'm going to show you guys what this kind of looks like. So if I press play, you'll see this line right here is kind of turning, and then you'll see this video is kind of moving in the background. So how I kind of added those two things was I basically went to view slide master, and now if you see here, I have a gradient box that's just on top of my footage, and then I have my headshot right here, my text, my circle, and subscribe. You can say whatever you want and place whatever you want as long as you know that it's not covering over that other stuff in the thumbnail. Where I got this footage is I actually got it from pexels.com. There's also tools like pixabay.com that also has royalty free videos that you could use for this project. So once you have that video, I would just place it in here. Then you can go to animations, animation pane, and then you just want to make sure that it's playing. So you just want to say always start with previous, and then you can also go here to play, and then you should be good to go for it to just play automatically. If I click on this video again for playback, you just want to make sure also that with the start it's automatically looped until stop, and then you should be good to go with that. So I'm just going to undo this a bunch so it's back like that. And I also just put this color overlay on top of this video because the video wasn't the color I wanted it to be, so I just kind of put my own branding colors with this. If I right click this format shape, it just is a gradient fill of a bunch of different oranges and reds, and then I made them slightly transparent just so that video can come through a little bit. Obviously you don't want like crazy busy because you want people to focus on like maybe subscribing or clicking on either of those videos, so it's just a nice subtle thing. And I put this all in the slide master. Now you don't have to put this in the slide master for this to work, but I like to put it in the slide master because that way if I want to add anything on top of it, I don't have to worry about moving the video around and like worrying about my other designs getting in the way. So the last touch that I added here were a bunch of these icons that you see right here. So I actually got these icons from the nounproject.com. So you do have to credit the author if you use their icons, but there is a paid option, and that's the option I'm using right now. And it allows you to basically use any type of icon you would like for your projects. So I just kind of searched up a bunch of different icons like a crop tool, shapes, animations, text, and then added those in just as a nice border. And then now when my end screen pops up like this, you're gonna see that suggested video shows, and then recommended, and then also my profile pic is showing as well. So it's super easy to do. It's not too complicated. And another thing is let's say you got this all ready to go. Your end screen's looking great. When you're exporting, make sure you have all the other slides that you're not wanting in the video to be hidden, because otherwise they're gonna be included in the video, so it's gonna look kind of weird. So make sure, and then you can go to File, Export, Create Video, 10 seconds. And you can also choose like if you want to be in 4K, you also have that option as well. Another thing is let's say it's just a still image and nothing's moving in the end screen. Then what you can do is you go to File, Export, and then you can do Change File Type, and then just do JPEG. And then you could submit that JPEG in the end screen features, and then that end screen picture will pop up, and then your videos that are suggested and your thumbnail will also pop up, but nothing will be really moving in the background. After you finish creating the end screen, this is where you can go. So right now I have my elements right here and this. So you may be wondering, okay, I made my end screen, now where do I upload it to be included in my videos? So you actually have to add your end screen to your raw footage that you're editing in a video editor. So if you have like iMovie, Adobe Premiere Pro, you can add it in there. And basically I added in just this 10 second clip at the end of my footage with some music just to make it look really nice. And then YouTube does the rest in terms of including those pop-up videos and then also your profile icon. Again, you could just have one profile icon or just one recommended video. You can really customize. You can put like both videos side by side and then your profile picture in the center. However you want, make sure you move it around however you would like right here. And then once you like how it looks right there, make sure to take a screenshot of that. And then you can start designing your end screen template in PowerPoint. All right, so that is how you can create an end screen easily in PowerPoint for your YouTube videos. If you did like this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. Also, if you could subscribe, I would really appreciate the support. It's free to do, so please do that. Also, if you are interested in learning more things about PowerPoint, I do offer a course on Udemy, so I have a link to that in the description below. But without further ado, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I hope to see you guys in future videos. Thanks.